We're back.
Yes.
Yes. Here we go. What is this game here? Where are we on the draw?
Oh, somewhere around 10:30-ish.
Okay, where can I see it on this piece of paper? Oh, down here in the corner here. Elgin out of Surrey, BC versus St. Francis Xavier out of Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. And what would this be? Maybe the winner would be the...
Something-ish place?
I don't know. Maybe eighth, ninth place game? We don't know.
Something around there.
Something around there. Quick turnaround. Last night, the St. Francis Xavier were paired up against Walter Murray Marauders out of Saskatoon in a game that started last night at about 8:30 at night. So they're back here pretty early in the morning. Quick turnaround. The Rams ended up losing a heartbreaker. They had a chance right at the end for a last point shot. The three-point shot that they made would have won them the game. Came up a little short, missed. Walter Murray wins the game. Walter Murray finds himself in the semifinals against Regina Riffle here at 3 o'clock.
Yo, first 2 points of the game there.
I like it. Who is that? Number 12. Kai Hamill, I think. Oh, no, my bad. Number 7, Kyan Compo. I got Rory up in the booth. Rory, grade 12 student at Bedford Road.
Oh, yeah.
How you feeling about this Brit? This is your, technically, what should be your fourth Brit. It's your second Brit.
Actually, only the second, yeah.
Couple were at grade 10 canceled, grade 11 canceled. But really, you are among the very few Bedford Road students who have actually seen a Brit for the rest of the school. Unless you're in grade 12, the rest of the school hasn't even seen a Brit before.
Yeah, the grade 9s, 10s, and 11s haven't even seen any, unless they went with their elementary schools.
Oh, that's right. We always bring the elementary schools and pack the gym on the Thursday and Friday, hey?
Yeah.
Did you come with your elementary school?
I did. I think in my grade 8 year I came.
Sweet. And what'd you think?
Oh, it was fun.
Nice. And I got Rory up in the booth here today, and hopefully get him up here a few more times. But Rory, you do a lot here for Brit. Tell us about a few things you're involved in.
For Brit?
Yeah.
Well, I've been announcing and also just working some music, then up here.
Sweet. Music, announcing, doing some booth. Beyond Brit, what else are you involved in at Bedford Road?
A couple things.
Well, tell us about them.
I'm the co-president. That's pretty fun.
Nice. What does a co-president do?
I'm kind of like the queen.
Okay.
Just a public figure.
You're the face, so you don't see much? You're just the looks?
Well, I do stuff. I'm also just the looks, though.
I'll tell you what, Bedford Road could do worse, that's for sure. You're a handsome fella.
Oh, shoot. Speak for yourself.
Oh, please. You're too kind. And selfishly, I know we're hoping that students like you who've been giving to Brit and their time here at Bedford Road, we always hope that students like you continue to come and give back once you've graduated. So selfishly, I hope this year is the first year you're up in the booth, but not the last. I hope it's the first of many.
Well, it's pretty fun, so I hope to be back next year some more, too.
Nice. Loving it. Let's go. Whoa! Number 6. Lucien Yamin, pardon me. No, I'm looking at the wrong team here. We got our things backwards. We got our sheets backwards. We're messing up everything here. Number 6, Andre Fabin gets fouled. 2-2 game here. 3 minutes in. If you had to predict who wins this game, who are you betting your money on? If I give you $100 right now and you had to bet it on a team, who are you betting?
I would go for Elgin Park, personally.
Elgin Park, okay.
They had some good showings early on. First game was a blowout.
That's right. Both these teams are good. All I know is the first game for both teams caught my attention. They both had dunks in their games.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't play each other, but in both their games, I saw a dunk in the first minute from both these teams, and that always gets my attention.
Oh, yeah. That's a big crowd pleaser there.
Totally. And coming from a guy, I can't even touch the bottom of the net when I jump. So to see these guys like get above the rim and dunk, I'm just like, this is incredible.
Yeah, the verticals on some of these guys is amazing.
It is amazing. For three.
Not quite.
Oof. What was that here? That was the Orcas. Evan Castle had his pass deflected out of bounds. Adam Olson's going to inbound the ball for the Orcas. Connor Gill has it up top, looking for somewhere to go. Olson has it, down low to Castle. Castle trying to find some room. Thought he might have got fouled there, didn't. Orcas pick up the rebound. Dylan Hominick ended up trying to get a shot there, but also had it blocked. Couple tries. Nothing actually touched the rim, I don't think. St. FX, Sean Brodeur. With the two, they're up 3-5-2. Low scoring game early on.
Only 7 points so far in the first 4 minutes.
Foul. Who's number 7, Keenan Compo. Or Keenan Compo.
But subbing on is Tristan Thompson.
He's into the game here. Orcas, Maddox Harrison inbounds the ball. Connor Gill has it. Back to Harrison. Harrison pull-up jumper. Nope, rebounds up for grabs. The Orcas recover. Gill has it at the top. Harrison. Oh. Hominick ended up getting the shot. Does it? Hey! What I just noticed, they have their names on the back of their jerseys for the Orcas.
Oh, yeah, it's fancy over there.
Yeah, holy cow. That actually, I think they might be one of the only teams that I've ever seen that actually comes in with custom jerseys with the actual player last names on the back.
Definitely the only team this year.
Totally. That's helpful to us and actually really cool. That's a personal touch.
Makes commentating so much easier.
What's the budget of that Orcas program? If they could fly from Surrey to Brit, if they got personalized jerseys here, holy cow.
Guessing they have a couple of dollars saved up.
That'd be my guess.
One or two.
Okay, St. FX has the ball here. Working it around. Number 6, Andre Fabin. Hits it. St. Francis up 7-4. Under 3 to go in the first quarter. Bit of a slow start as far as points go. Lots of action.
Four for three.
That's Olson. Got ourselves a tie game here.
Oh, yeah.
The big man, Akin, for St. Francis Xavier, gets hacked. He's listed at 6'8", and he looks every inch a 6'8".
That's almost a foot taller than I am.
Yep. Holy cow. And then imagine, like, if you had your hands up and he had his arms up, like, I bet you his reach is probably 2 feet taller than both of us.
Oh, probably. We wouldn't even reach his elbows.
No, I don't think so. Look at the arms on this guy. I bet you he can almost touch the rim just standing there.
I would not be surprised.
Holy cow. And actually comparing him to number 22 of the Orcas, Dylan Hominick, who's also 6'8". I was going to say, these guys look like they're both about the same height. So two guys at 6'8" on the court right now. Holy cow.
There's some big guys in this tournament.
Yeah, there is. What are they putting in the water?
Those, we should get some of that here at Bedford.
Yeah, no kidding. Olsen for three. That's his second in a row. He's heating up. Gives Elgin their first lead of the game. Down low, Thompson has it. The three-point shot. Oh, they're scrambling for the ball underneath. Akin came up with it, but ended up giving it away. He was looking for someone under the net. Missed. 4-3. That was Harrison. No good.
And the Hominick foul.
Picked up the rebound. He gets fouled. He's going to shoot two. Char Akin got called at the foul. Little substitution here. The St. FX coach is going deeper into his bench this morning than yesterday. We're seeing a few faces in the game this morning that we didn't get to see last night in their quarterfinal game against Walter Murray. Love that, trying to give more players some playing time, some Brit experience. St. Francis Xavier won Brit back in 2017. And my guess is the coach is thinking, well, I hope we get to come back next year. So probably trying to give some of those grade 11 players some experience so that next year when they get here, they know what to expect. Olsen stole the ball there, but ended up giving it away. Drives, that's Thompson. Misses the layup.
Still only 18 points scored so far.
Yeah, this is, I want to say there's a game yesterday, and I forget which game it was. Maybe it's the Holy Cross game to Walter Murray. But one of the teams had 27 and the other one had 20. Like we had almost 50 points scored in that first quarter, which is a pretty stark difference to what we're seeing here this morning. Whoa, Olsen, the big man. 6'7". So the Orcas, 6'7", 6'8", 6'5" on the court right now. There'd be few high school teams, I would think, that'd be able to measure up with that kind of size.
Lots of passing going on here, but no shooting.
No, they're really slowing it down, setting it up for that last second shot maybe here. Looking for something from the corner. Oh, Kalen Smith didn't get that to go.
No.
Trying to set up that buzzer beater type situation here.
That's the end of the first quarter.
There we go. At the end of the first quarter, Elgin out of Surrey, 12. St. FX out of Edmonton, 8. Let's turn off the mics for a minute, give our voice a rest. See you in a few minutes. Right, we're back. We were jamming Black Betty. Who doesn't love a little Black Betty on the loudspeakers?
Well, everyone loves some Black Betty.
Oh, arms in the air, fists pumping. Second quarter action here. We're back. St. FX had the lead there early on, but Elgin Park has sort of been gaining momentum here as we go. I'll tell you, this tournament isn't just about basketball. Like we were just jamming out there at the quarter break here. It's about the loud music. It's about the halftime shows. It's about right after this game, we've got the Bedford Road Dance Showcase, and we've got a whole bunch of curricular dance teams or dance classes coming from around the city. A bunch of schools are bringing their dance classes, showing off what their dance programs are doing. It's going to be a packed gym, so not just about basketball here. There's so much more.
Yeah, it's a complete grit experience. It's really an amazing thing.
I've been calling it the most electrifying event in sports entertainment to hit Saskatoon, maybe ever.
Yeah, it's a huge tournament, and it's really gets the whole city together.
It really does. And I think we even have some elementary school dance programs come in, so not just high school either. Get down here today. We're talking on the live stream, and if you're watching from outside of Saskatoon, you're tuning in from Edmonton and you're checking out St. FX, or you're cheering in from Surrey, tuning in from Surrey and cheering on Elgin. Hey, we get it. Live stream, rock it. Give us your positive comments. Spread those links to your friends. But if you're watching from Saskatoon today, I'm going to challenge you. If you can, get down here to the gym. This is one of the nicest days we've had for Brit. It's like -2 out there. It's usually -50.
It's so warm.
Like, get in your car, come down here, spend the $8, spend the day here, check out the action.
And you can get a Brit dog.
Yes, you can get Dilly bars are supposed to be getting here today. Ooh. Saturday, we always got Dilly bar. Donuts, Brit dogs. Taco in a bag.
Pizza. Oh,
pizza. How can you forget the pizza? But the concession's rocking. And we got a million different options for you. We got entertainment all day. Bring your kids. Bring your friends. Spend the day. Make this Kelly Bowers Gymnasium your home for the day. Family-friendly entertainment. Be part of something special here. Hey, number 14, Massimo Filamino. That's a cool name, rolls off the tongue.
That is a nice name. Kind of wish I had that name now.
Yeah, actually, me too. My name sucks in comparison.
Yeah, all of our names suck compared to that.
Whoa, awesome. He's loving it. We saw him get two back-to-back threes in the first quarter. The guy, what's he listed at? Like, listen, that's where 6'7". A guy who's 6'7" and he can shoot threes like that. What?
That's a pretty good player, if you ask me.
Yeah. And we're talking about all these big guys on the court here. What I've been watching is the two smallest guys on the court for Elgin Park. We got number 8, Nate Funk. He's listed at 5'9". I'm guessing he's more like 5'7". He's been battling it out with number 6, Andre Fabin, who's also listed at 5'8". My guess is he's about 5'7". So we're talking about these big guys, but what I've kind of been keeping my eye on is the two smallest guys on the court here. They're fast.
Oh, yeah. They have to make up for the lack of height.
That's right, and they are. And they're making up for it with heart.
Oh, yeah.
Some guys have height, other guys have heart. And I guess, you know, the guys with height have heart, too. I shouldn't say that.
They all have heart.
They all have heart. You're absolutely right. They all have heart.
Yeah, we need a heart to live.
You know what? Biologically speaking, I think we do need a heart to live. I don't know. Yeah. I'm not a real scientist, but I think there's merit to what you just said.
Pardon?
Funk from the corner. Oh, big rebound. Who came up with that? Number 11, Sean Brodeur. He's going to go end-to-end.
Ooh,
doesn't
misses.
Get it to go. Takes a couple hacks. Huh.
Kind of thought, work his ball.
I thought there might have been a foul or two. Kind of looked like there was a couple opportunities to call the foul. The refs are sitting on their whistles today, letting the boys play. Number 11 for the York. Davis McDonald's going to inbound the ball. He's into the game here. Olsen has it. We've been saying his name a lot.
Oh, once or twice?
A couple times. Mohan Gill here. Haven't seen him yet. He's into the game.
Olsen with the ball again.
Down low to Gill. Again, no foul called. Oh. Talking about the short guys, the speedster, Andre Fabin, kind of drives down the middle and then made that last second dish, looking to get an assist. Doesn't get it, but does get the foul. Massimo Filomeno. He's going to shoot, too. Oh.
That's a fun name.
Oh, I hope he gets to shoot more, because I just want to say his name about 100 more times.
Well, I want to say his name now.
You don't get to.
Massimo Filomeno. See, I just said it.
That's good.
Oh, yeah.
That's good. Rolls off the tongue. Elgin out of Surrey, 19, St. FX 13, 6-point game. Lots of time left. Oh!
Ooh. Throws it out of bounds.
Ouch. McDonald ripped a pass there. Negamatsu couldn't hold on to it. Campo from the corner. That's Fabin. Doesn't get it to go. Gill picks up the rebound.
Olsen again.
Down low to Funk. He likes that corner. Oh, decides not to shoot. Drives. Gets fouled. The speedy little Funk. He's going to shoot too. Oh, he's not going to shoot too. Okay, he's going to inbound the ball. Foul was called though.
Looked like he was going to shoot.
He's ready for it. Orca's going to inbound the ball. McDonald up top. Looking for Funk in the corner to Gill. Olsen. 7 seconds on the shot clock. Going to set something up. 3 seconds. Olsen with the three. Doesn't get it to go. Rebound picked up by Akin. All 6'8" of them got up there, picked up that ball. Number 10, Tristan Thompson, going for the layup. He gets fouled.
He's going to take a couple shots here.
Put a couple up. Hey, I was just thinking, actually, what time is it? About 11 o'clock, something like that?
Something like that.
I was 11:16. So in British Columbia, it's only 9:15 in the morning.
Ooh.
So I wonder if there are any Elgin Park fans who got up early this morning to tune into the live feed. If there are, hit us up on the stream. Give us some comments. Tell us a little bit about your team. Of course, coming all the way from Surrey, BC, like we don't know much about your school, your team, your program. Any of that information is fun for us to share with our listeners. So if you're listening to the live stream, get on. Give us some information. Oh, we got Aaron Harrison tuning in. Said, of course we're here. They're watching. They're cheering on the boys. Love it.
And that's probably Maddox Harrison's family members there.
You're good. You're good at deduction here. I would guess maybe a parent, a sibling, a grandparent of Maddox Harrison. Great to hear that you're tuning in. I hope you're proud of the boys and the way they're playing. I hope they get home and tell you stories about what a great tournament this was. Hopefully they're making memories that are going to last a lifetime here. Olsen from the corner. All the way
long
across
pass
to Gill. Holy, that was transcontinental. Holy, look at this. Hominick.
Traveling called.
Big guy, Hominick. You see this? It's 6'8". Come on.
He's a little bit tall, I guess.
Yeah. And some of these kids, I'm reminding myself, it's like they're only in high school. Like, there's nothing preventing these guys from growing another 3 inches. You know, they might not even be done yet.
They're going to be giants.
They already are, some of them.
True.
And I'm just thinking, you know, you're young, you know, you don't have any kids yet, I don't think. I don't have any kids.
Not that I know of.
Okay, good. But to be a parent of one of these guys, like, what's your food bill? Do you just buy hay bales and put them in the backyard and let them graze? Like, I can't imagine what your Costco bill is.
Definitely need a Costco membership for this, though. Like, that
you gotta get
food.
A second job just to feed these horses.
They just grow their own food in the back.
You must have to, and I guess if you're coming out from BC, like, you probably could. You know, with the weather you got, you might be able to have a little backyard farm to help offset the cost.
Maybe that's why they're so big. They can eat more.
That's true. Gill wanted to shoot it there. Give him some of the pass too. He's got Castle. Oh, ooh, bounced off the rim close. A couple times. Hominick picked up the rebound, gets fouled. What I like seeing here today is not that this game, just the fact that this is a B-side game and the winner doesn't get to kind of move on in the A-side. So coaches on both teams looks like are spreading out the love and allowing more players to get in the game and experience it. So I really like seeing that.
And that'll help prepare them for next year, too, if they're invited back. Gives them experience.
That's right. So they're going to get here next year knowing exactly what to expect. They can be leaders on the team next year. People on the live stream love it, saying, let's go, Elgin. We got some fans here. I also have someone going, hey, I can't remember now. When was the first Brit? Rory, when was the first Brit?
Well, that was in 1968, and Bedford won that year, actually.
That was the first and only Bedford Road Brit title back in 1968. Very cool. Olsen. Oh, ooh. Yeah! You can see that coming a mile away. As soon as he had that ball, I'm like, he's going to dunk this. I know he is. Why wouldn't you? You're that big. You know you can.
Oh, yeah. Makes you look good, too.
Oh, yeah. If I could, I would.
Wish I could dunk.
Yeah, me too. That'd be the best. What do we got here? 22-16, 6-point game with a minute 33 left in the first half. This is a close one. Low scoring, but close. We got Fabin pulls up, shoots, no go. Harrison picks up the rebound. He's going to carry the ball up the court. Looking around, gets it to Gill. Gill to Hominick. Hominick, the spin move. He gets fouled on the play. Number 14, Massimo Filamino. He can't believe he got called on that foul.
That's such a nice name.
I know.
I don't even care about the foul. I just like the name.
I hope he fouls more just so I can say his name more.
Yeah, just four times, though. Then he can make some shots.
That's right. That's right. Oh, he's going to come out of the game. Into the game, we got Sean Brodeur. Brodeur is an easy one to remember. I always think about the NHL goalie Martin Brodeur.
Oh, yep, that guy.
Do you recognize that name? Or are you too young to recognize Martin Brodeur as a name?
I recognize the name.
Yeah, okay, okay.
Work in a sports store. I see frames of him.
You work in a sports store?
Oh, yeah.
Are they a Brit sponsor?
No.
Well, then I can't ask you what
sports
store you work.
No, I cannot say the name.
But I will say Go Sports.
Yeah, Go Sports of all kinds.
Oh, number five. Wow, nifty little spin move. That was Joel Bidiakko. Nice move there. Gill. Whoa.
Close.
Look at the heart. Yeah, he got fouled on that. Now we got some of the shorter guys on the court here. Number 12, Kai Hamill, listed at 5'10". It's sort of the three shortest guys on the court there who are just battling it out. Who's into the game here? Johan Gill is into the game for the Orcas.
Actually have three Gills on that team.
Oh, I wonder what the relation is. Are these brothers?
You'd think so, but maybe not. You never know.
Mohan Gill, Jahan Gill, and Connor Gill. Very cool. Connor Gill made the free throw. Under a minute to go in the half. 5-point game from the corner. 3-point shot. Misses. Ooh. That was Desi with the 3-point shot. And then Brodeur tried to get the rebound and ended up putting it out of bounds. It's going to be Orca ball. Olsen's going to inbound it to Gill. We got Aaron Harrison chiming in on the live chat saying, no relation. Three Gills, three Gill fellas on the Orca team. Not related.
That's surprising.
That is surprising. Maybe Gill is just a big name in Surrey basketball.
You never know.
Maybe.
Just out in BC, is that where they're from?
Yeah, close to Vancouver.
Oh, okay. Out there, there's a lot of Gills, I guess.
I guess so. They're in some direction from Vancouver. Probably not west, because west of Vancouver is the ocean. So my guess, they're either north, south, or east.
I mean, they are
Vancouver.
The Orcas, so they could be west.
Maybe they're from under the sea.
Maybe.
I don't know. And actually, what a cool name. The Orcas? I just actually thought about that. Orcas, like, can you find a better animal? Like, a cooler animal than the killer whale?
Like, it's a good animal.
It's a even sweet animal.
Look at the Brit poster behind us. It's a nice poster.
Whoa! That is a cool poster. For those of you who don't know at home, every year, the Brit art department puts together these massive panels, and each team that comes gets this awesome panel drawn up with like their mascot, their name, their logo, and those panels decorate our gym for the entire year. You can kind of see it in your shot right now, looking across. You can see the Brit logo panel there. You can see the dance panel. In behind us are the panels for all the teams, and you're right, the Orcas is cool.
Oh yeah.
Orcas, I think, are the only animals that can kill killer whales, or no, what's the big shark? Great white sharks.
Great white sharks, oh yeah.
Killer whales can take down a great white shark.
I actually did not know that. Taught me something today.
I might have just made that up. I make up a lot of things on here.
That's fair.
Do not fact check anything I say.
I kind of feel like most of this is just making stuff up.
It is. Hey, we should take a break here for halftime, but let's recap. I feel like I got sidetracked there. What's the score here?
25-18 for Elgin.
Going into halftime, 7-point lead. We're taking a little break here. Stay tuned. Come back for some second half action.
So
right, we're back. Second half action. Give us a little recap. Where are we at here, Rory?
Oh, Elgin is leading 25-18, and that's a soft G. It is not pronounced Elgin. We learned that during the break.
We did, so we can learn.
Yeah.
We were saying Elgin the whole first half. Someone's like, actually, it's a soft G, and I was like, I don't know what you actually mean by that. And then they're like, it's Elgin. And I was like, oh.
Yeah, so.
Whoops.
Sorry, Elgin Park, about that.
Yeah, whoops-a-daisy. I mean, and I got to apologize, too. Like, I imagine I'm saying almost every single name wrong.
Probably. It's bound to happen.
We're doing our best. You know, I'm not doing it on purpose. You know, I'm just, reading is hard.
Yeah. You know, I got some of the pronunciations for when I was announcing, but.
And you know who is, like, the king of enunciation? Is Hewton.
Hewton.
Across there, you know, Jordy Hewton?
Oh, Jordy, yeah.
Right?
I just knew his first name.
Oh, you didn't? Okay, no, Jordy Hewton, the guy who's been doing the announcing from the score table across here, like, he's been doing it at Brit for 20 years. He did CIS basketball for years and years and years. He is a professional.
I believe he's doing the Huskies as well currently.
Yep, he does, like, he does it professionally. The dude knows what he's doing. So whenever I kind of don't know what's going on, I'm like, hey, how do you pronounce his name? He always gets it right. I always get it wrong. So I apologize.
Just those years of experience coming in handy.
He's good. And continues to come back to Brit and donate his time like 20 years after he's graduated to give us the best. And then also to help train our next generation of announcers, such as yourself.
Oh, yeah, that would be me.
You've been training you this year. Hey, you've gotten on the score table doing the announcement for the in-gym. How do you like that?
Oh, it's fun. Sweet. And he has Ripley down there right now, too, training him up.
I like it. And I think the expectation, or at least the hope, is guys like you who've got some experience are going to come back after you've graduated and maybe help out. Do you think that's a possibility? Could Britt get you back in the gym next year doing some work?
Oh, I think if they tried not very hard, they could get me back.
Yes! I'll tell you, because, Rory, it really is people like you who make this tournament happen. If it wasn't for alumni like Jordy, hopefully you and Sweet, that Nabby I see working the score table, I hope you guys continue to come back year after year after year, because if you don't, I'm not sure how long this tournament can continue to go on, to be honest.
True. It kind of does run on those people coming back, like yourself, this year.
You're right. And I do it because I love it. This is fun. Like, I don't view this as like, oh, I got to come to Brit and work. I'm like, I get to come back to Brit again this year and be a part of it. Like, to me, it's an honor.
And I found that people do such a better job when they enjoy it. Just.
You're absolutely right. When you have to be here, you're not doing it with the same heart.
No. Just not the same.
It's not. Whoa! Oh, boy. Hard foul. And is that Hominick, Olsen, Harrison? Who is that down on the ground? I can't see the number.
Can't either.
But went down hard. Looked like
there's
Harrison,
number one.
I think. Looked like maybe a shoulder smash in the ground like that. I'll tell you, there's no hold in the back of his neck. This is never what you want to see is anyone getting hurt out here.
He's going to be subbed off here, looks like.
He's walking it off, which is always a good thing to see, but he's holding his shoulder. Hopefully he's going to be okay. You obviously want to see everyone playing at 100% and laying it on the line, but you never want to see anyone get hurt out here.
Well, that's not what this tournament is about.
And of course with basketball, there's no pads, no helmets, no masks. This is hard wood, as they call it. Holy cow.
Ooh.
You and I have just been up here rambling for 3 minutes. We didn't.
Oh.
We look up. St. FX is up.
Wow.
What was the score? Like 25-16 or something?
Something like that. They've come back and they're winning now.
St. FX is on a run here in the second half. Another steal for St. FX. This is like, what, maybe a 10-point run. And they've got the lead. The Orcas yet to score a point here in the first 4 minutes of the half.
They might not let us ramble anymore.
Well, we got to pay attention to the game. St. FX on a little bit of a tear here to start the half.
They have a couple free throws here as well.
Favin's going to shoot two. I don't know what head coach Brad Farish said to the boys at halftime, but he must have said something inspirational because they've come out hot.
Oh, yeah. Something must have clicked.
Hey, I'm tuning into the live chat. I gotta say thanks to Huma Goat. It says, Schumacher, how did he get so cool? I just gotta say, I'm old. I have never been called cool in my life. So Huma Goat, first time ever. One person in the world thinks I'm cool. Thank you so much.
But you're the coolest. How's no one ever called you cool before?
My goodness, you guys are too good to me. And we were talking at halftime. Huma Goat, we think that's Hasnan.
I think so.
Hasnan Ali, grade 12, Bedford Road. Got to play in his first Brit this year as a grade 12 student.
He's number 3 on Bedford Road's team.
Love that guy. Absolutely love that guy. And he's a fella who's been coming to Brit since he's in elementary school. He had 3 older siblings go to Bedford Road. So he comes from a long line of great all of his siblings, great academically. He's great academically. Nice people.
Oh, yeah.
I was fortunate enough to be able to work with both of his older sisters. Who are some of the nicest people, hard workers, brilliant academically. So Hasnan, thank you to you and your family for all you brought to Bedford Road over the years, and I hope continue to bring to Bedford Road over the years.
Now Elgin is back up again.
What? This is awesome. I absolutely love this.
Maybe we should start rambling more. No, it's getting more exciting.
That's true. Now what I would love to see here, overtime. I just love overtime.
That would be fun.
It's a 1-point game right now, so overtime is like, it's a possibility here.
And Mitchell the ball went out of bounds.
And right after this game, we're actually taking a pause from the basketball action, and we're doing the dance showcase. You can kind of see, as I look around, Rory, our side of the gym is starting to fill up here, as I think some dance parents are starting to get in the building here.
I think so. And whenever the dancers come out too, it'll get nice and full.
Oh, it's going to be nuts in here. And I'd like to treat these dance parents to maybe a little bit extra basketball, some overtime.
That would be nice.
Let's delay that dance competition a few minutes here and give them some overtime.
Oh yeah, get some more basketball in. Ooh.
Oh, 4-3 for the Orcas. Who's that? Josh Ray.
Yeah.
You know, talking about overtime and the dance competition, all this kind of stuff. I go way back. I'm going right with this one here. I'm going back to Brit 2001.
That's before I was even born.
Thanks for that, you jerk. You're right, it was. But Brit 2001, it was right before, it was this game, right before the cheer and dance competition. It used to be a competition at that time, and the gym is packed. The longest game in Brit history, it was the Mount Royal Mustangs. And why I remember so much is I'm a Mount Royal guy. This is my high school, and I got to watch my buddies playing this game, like the likes of Michael Linklater, Scott Bevan, who's a teacher here at Bedford Road, played in that game. It was the longest game in Brit history. Went to 3 overtimes.
Wow.
We had dance and cheer parents here just like, come on, we want to watch this dance. Mount Royal didn't care. Mike Linklater didn't care when he hit his 3rd buzzer beater to send it into the 3rd overtime. He didn't care what they wanted. In the end, Mount Royal won it. Won the longest game in Brit history. So you just reminded me of that. So I had to go back through the files in my brain here and share some of that history with the fans.
That is 3 buzzer beaters by the same guy?
Same guy.
Wow.
And Mike Linklater, he spoke yesterday at the breakfast. And I'm not going to do him justice at all, not one bit. So I'm not even going to try to share his story, but I do remember a few of his accolades. So, competed in Brit as a high school student, went on to play college in the U.S., came back north, played for the University of Saskatchewan Huskies, and helped them win their first national title in 2010, went on to represent Canada for the 3-on-3, traveled the world with 3-on-3 basketball Canada. Just most recently, his last year playing before his retirement, played professionally in the CEBL for the Saskatoon Rattlers and helped them win a championship.
That is quite a resume.
Yeah, and it started here in this gym with Brit, and he spoke yesterday kind of talking about some of his experiences with grit, his experiences being an indigenous man, and some of the challenges that he faced kind of growing up. So he shared that with his players, and some of the wisdom that he has is just invaluable. And he continues to give back to the basketball community and continues to inspire young people.
I'd certainly like to meet this guy. He sounds like an amazing man.
He is, well, I mean, we're getting people on the live chat. Jeremiah Johnson, Michael Legend. Mike Linklater is a legend in our community. And, like, that's the right word. He's a legend.
Oh, yeah, he's a legend.
But the only thing is, like, I feel like a legend, you call someone a legend when they're done. And Mike Linklater might be done playing competitive basketball, but he's not done making an impact in the basketball communities, in those First Nations communities. He is not done. In fact, I think he's probably just getting started. And another chiming in from the live chat, Catherine J says, we are about, and I assume she's talking about Elgin and Surrey, we're about 1 hour southeast of Vancouver, 5 minutes from the U.S. border. So thanks. You and I were having a tough job with geography.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
I don't know.
Like, I thought they were in the ocean.
They're the orcas.
Yeah.
Like, who knows?
Like, they don't really look like actual orcas, but you never know.
No. They're killer players, not killer whales.
Amazing players on this team. Now they're up 34-31 against St. FX.
Yeah, you and I got yakking, also we looked up, like, whoa, St. FX is all of a sudden ahead, but then Elgin has kind of come back since then.
Yeah, they brought it back a little bit.
3-point game here, under 10 seconds to go in the third quarter. Who do we got here? Number 5, Joel Bediako. He's going to shoot 2. Hopefully narrow that lead to 1 point.
That's a fun name as well.
Bediako?
Yeah.
And we're probably saying it wrong.
Oh, probably.
But I like the way we say it.
I do too. Bediako.
The clock winds down. What do we got here?
Elgin Park with 34, and they're leading St. FX. Only has 32.
2-point game. Stay tuned. We're talking overtime. Wouldn't mind seeing some. We got a little third quarter break. Stay tuned for fourth quarter action. Back with fourth quarter action here, 2-point game. Before we do, maybe we should give a shout out to some of these sponsors. Who we got here?
Oh, we got a couple. We got Dakota Dunes Community Development Corporation, Tamico, Trail Appliance, Seth Tell Laser Autobody, Red Redicop with MP Saskatoon West, Ham Construction, Polygon Water. Everyone needs a drink of water now and then.
Yep, stay hydrated.
Rex Scaffolding, Smiley's, Husky Athletics, and Me Sports.
Thank you to all our sponsors. We could not put on a tournament. Well, we could put on a tournament, but we could not put on a tournament to this caliber without great sponsors like you.
No, it would not be the same.
It'd be lame.
Yeah.
It's these sponsors. It's them shelling out the bucks. It's them being willing to invest in their community that puts up, that allows us to put on an event like this.
Well, and the Saskatoon Rattlers put on a halftime show with the 3-on-3 tournament.
That's right. Big sponsors for that. Fun.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that 3-on-3 tournament, that is... That schools from around Saskatoon submit 3 players each from their junior teams to participate in the 3-on-3 at halftime.
Yeah, it was fun. And then they had their mascot coming out and walking around, interacting with the crowd, too.
Oh, yeah, the Rattler guy was walking around. Hopefully we see him again tonight.
Well, it looks like Santa Fex has taken the lead again.
Back and forth, back and forth.
Close, not quite.
I love people chiming in on the live chat because all this stuff is just so cool, and I gotta say it. Jeremiah Jones, thank you. He says to kind of add to the Mike Linklater legend, he's giving us some information. I gotta say this. He says, in the North American Indigenous Games in Denver of 06, Team Saskatchewan needed an 800-meter runner. My guess is Mike Linklater was probably there competing in basketball. But he said the Saskatchewan team needed an 800-meter runner, so Linklater said, okay, I'll do it. The guy comes home with a silver medal.
Of course he does.
Yeah, of course he does. Just like, fine, you need someone to run. I bet you said, like, hey, we need someone to do high jump. He probably would have came home with a medal with that too.
Oh, shot probably.
But, like, what do you need? He'll play badminton for you and win you a medal.
He'll get something.
The guy's awesome. Hey, I love that information. If you got cool information like that about your team, about past players from Grit, like, give it to us. You know, we love sharing these things, and it helps us learn and get better too. So thank you for that. It's awesome. 1-point game, St. Francis Xavier up. 6.5 to go.
Ooh, there's Elgin Park with 2 more points.
Gill with the nifty little layup. Pull up jumper. Off the front of the rim, doesn't go. Gill gets the rebound.
Nice deke there.
Castle for 3. Doesn't go. That's Fabian, who picks up the rebound. Oh, blistering pass that Desi couldn't hang on to. Couldn't even get a finger on it. About a foot too far in front of him.
Looks like Elgin's coach might even be taller than Adam Olsen, who's 6'7".
Yep. Okay, so I don't know all the facts about, but Kurt Hominick is the fella you're talking about. And I got a chance to learn early in the tournament a little bit about Kurt Hominick. Saskatoon guy, did you know that?
Ah, nice.
So this is, and I might get a few of my facts wrong, but I'm trying to keep it straight here. Kurt Hominick, Saskatoon guy, played for Evan Hardy Collegiate in Saskatoon back in the late 80s, early 90s. Went on for a full ride scholarship to the University of Southern California.
California.
Played in Brit, was a Brit All-Star. I think he made it to a Brit final, but somehow ends up in Vancouver as their coach and brings his team back to Brit, the place where he got it all started. But someone told me the guy's 6'11".
Wow, that's
huge. 6'11".
That's over a foot taller than me.
Yeah. Like, that guy has to be the biggest guy in the arena, in every arena he's ever entered, ever.
Except for maybe, like, Shaq.
Maybe if you're watching a Lakers game and Shaq was there or something, like, maybe there's one person taller than him. I got to think, like, I just look at that and I'm like, whoa, that's crazy. Like, holy cow. And I'm like, man, that's got to suck for those plane rides.
Yes. And walking through doorways?
Right? You got to duck your head through everything. Like, sitting on WestJet, you got your knees up by your ears, I think, for 3.5 hours coming from Vancouver to Saskatoon.
Ooh, 3 points there. Elgin's pulling away a little bit, but St. FX is still in it.
Oh, 4-point game. Heck yeah. Especially with the way the second half is going, with a bunch of lead changes. Like, a 4-point lead kissed that goodbye in about 10 seconds.
Yep.
Oh, air ball.
For the rebound? Nope.
Nope. Hamill trying to sort of make up for it. He put up a three, didn't get any rims, so he wanted to make up for it by getting his own rebound. Did, got fouled. Now he's going to shoot two. Elgin taking the lead back. But Hamill trying to narrow that down to two. If he can hit both of these.
One's good.
First. Of course he hits his first.
Why wouldn't he?
Shot number two. Misses it. Rebounds up for grabs. The big man, Akin, gets it.
They only need a three to tie right
now. Possession game. Akin has it to Hamill. He's going to shoot three.
Ah, close.
Oh, that could have been the tie. Olsen picks it up. He can shoot the threes, but doesn't. Passes it down low to Castle. Drives hard. Gets it. Wanted the foul. He wanted to make it a three-point play. Smith, the turnaround hook shot, doesn't go. Olsen gets the rebound. Castle's calling for it in the middle. Olsen, the spin move. Outside to Gill, the three. Air ball. Rebound Smith. Hamill has it down low. Three-point shot for Adeyinka. One of the Gills has it. Gets fouled. Orca ball. Orca's going to inbound. Under 4 minutes to play in the second half.
Oh, out of bounds.
Five-point game. Elgin Park enjoying the lead right now.
Both teams still have all of their timeouts left.
That's right. Saving them for when it counts here. And this one might come down to the wire. Oh, inbound pass intercepted by Brodeur. Dishes it down low for the fast break. Easy layup there for Compo.
Makes that gap a little bit smaller.
Gill to Olsen. Olsen, spin move, fadeaway jumper, doesn't go. Castle picks up the rebound, misses. Thought he should have got a foul call there, doesn't. Brodeur got the rebound. Smith carrying it up the court for St. FX. Oh, Compo's got it picked out of his pocket there. Gill has it to McDonald. McDonald to the other Gill, to Olsen. Castle up top. Gonna drive, spin move. Gets the call he wanted there. He was looking for it a few times, didn't get it that time he did, so he gets the two and gets to shoot an additional.
Could be a three-point play here.
I think his coach would probably like that. That would extend the lead to six.
That's only two threes to catch up for St. FX.
Just wait, six is... three times two. No, you're right, though. Yeah, that's two three-pointers, yeah.
Counting is hard sometimes.
Yeah, sometimes. And that's not counting. You just hit me with some multiplication, dude.
I did use some multiplication.
You're gonna hit me with some advanced functions like that? You got to give me warning. I'll get my calculator out of my phone.
Okay, sorry. I'll warn you next time.
Smarty pants. I'm in high school. I know math. Like, come on. Quit bragging.
No, it's addition and subtraction is what I struggle with.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's what I'm good at. Anything beyond that is like, I don't know. Okay, number 10, who is that? Thompson picks up the rebound for St. FX. Six-point game from the corner.
Ooh.
Oh, Akapuyan.
Now it's a three-point game.
Cuts the lead in half. 44-41 Elgin.
Still 2 minutes left to go.
Plenty of time. Anything can happen here. Stay tuned. Olsen from the corner.
Misses.
Gill poked it out of bounds. Ooh, pardon me. It was like one of those little like yawn burps at the same time.
Oh, yeah, those. Yeah, I know those.
What do you call it? Yerps?
Something like that. You can call it yerps.
But it was weird. Sorry about that. Helping out with the score. 44-41 Elgin.
Ooh.
Pause that. 44-44.
Tie game.
Like you just mentioned, 2 3-pointers ties it up, and what happened?
It's tied up.
2 3-pointers tied it up. Minute and a half to go, tie game. I've been talking overtime for the last 20 minutes. You know I want to see it. Laying out for the ball, that's Brodeur.
These players are giving it their all.
Selling out on every play. That's why, like, you don't see this in professional basketball. These guys aren't playing for money. They're playing for heart. They're playing for their schools. And as a result, we're seeing them, like, laying it on the line. Bodies flying around into the sidelines.
They are putting their all into this match.
This is awesome. They're putting it on for us, the fans.
Yeah.
Right? They're putting on a show for us.
Oh, yeah. And finally, Elgin has used one of their timeouts. Or no, it's St. FX has used one of their timeouts.
Okay, the first time out of the half here as things narrow down. We're a minute and a half, well, a minute 18 away from the end of this game, tie game.
We might be forcing some dance parents to watch some extra basketball here.
Ooh, give them a little bit of treat, but you're absolutely right. Immediately following this, this is our dance showcase coming up, taking a pause for about an hour and a half of the basketball. But after the dance showcase, we have the first semifinal at 1:30. Tell us about it.
It'll be between Raymond and Holy Cross. That'll be a good game to watch.
To me right now, that's a coin flip as far as who wins that game. Like on a normal year, a game like that, that could be your final.
Oh, definitely.
And then immediately following that semifinal between Raymond and Holy Cross, what do we got?
Oh, we got the next semifinal between Riffle and Walter Murray.
Oh, Regina versus Saskatoon.
And Walter Murray won by just 3 points against St. FX yesterday.
It was a barn burner. It was amazing to watch. Both teams like putting on a show for a that was a packed house last night.
Oh yeah.
Okay, back to the game here. With like a minute left here, tie game. We got to get into it. Olsen can't get to go. They're bobbling the rebound. Ref makes the call saying it was out on St. FX. So the Orcas are going to hold on to the ball.
Yep. In.
Minute 10 left in the game. Full shot clock. Olsen's going to inbound it. Inbounds the ball to Gill. Gill pull up jumper from the free throw line for two. Ooh, Elgin up 46-44. Minute to go. Sinifex outside.
This one's a nail biter.
Compo down low.
Ties it up again.
Kalen Smith for two, tie game. 50 seconds to go. Gill has it for the Orcas. To Olsen in the corner. Oh, Olsen gives it away. St. FX has it coming. No! To take the lead back. The St. Francis Xavier bench loves that. They're on their feet.
Another timeout is called here.
I think Coach Hominick called that timeout. Going to slow things down here, recompose himself. 36 seconds left. Orcas are going to get the ball. They're down two. Dancers, if you can see here, we got some dancers already lined up in the corners. They're chomping at the bit to hit the floor.
If we get into some overtime, they'll be standing there for a while.
They'll be standing there a while if what both you and I hope to happen happens.
Yeah.
But that's, I mean, they're just going to get a treat if that happens. They're going to get to watch some more of this awesome Brit basketball. And if that happens, it's easy. To make up the time, our score clock will just take their music and they'll speed it up to 1.5 tempos.
Oh, yeah.
So we get to watch these, like, sped up crazy fast dance routines.
Oh, yeah, that'll be fun.
Oh, that's going to be exciting.
Nothing can go wrong with that happening.
It's like, you know, a bunch of high school dancers just, like, rammed full energy drinks here.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm just kidding. We're not going to speed up the dances, but that would be something to see. Actually, I'd love to see one of those dance routines are, like, fast enough that they make my eyes blurry. Can you imagine them, like, sped up?
So it would be fun if we did them regular speed, then sped it up for a second time.
That'd be insane. I don't think that's possible to do.
No.
If you're a dancer, at least. Like, no way. Okay, Olsen, gonna inbound the ball, down two. 35 seconds left to go. Gill trying to create some space in the corner, getting smothered. Down low. Hominick.
Ooh.
Pivoting, looking to get that shot, doesn't. Gets fouled instead. Not going to shoot. They're going to inbound the ball. 14 seconds left on the shot clock. 28 seconds in the game. Score table slowing it down. Score table contacting. It looks like maybe they're saying that that's the fifth foul for that player. I saw it look like the number five being held up.
Oh, yeah.
No, like maybe a little mistake there. Okay, nope, doesn't look like it was a fifth foul here because that would have implications on the game.
So it's Davis McDonald coming in for the Orcas now.
Hey, Davis McDonald. Inbound to Olsen. He can shoot the three. Doesn't, though. Down low, up top to Gill. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Gill, pull-up jumper. Rebound up for Grouse. This is an important rebound.
Ooh.
Gill had it in his hands, bobbled it off his foot and went out. He's on the ground. I hope he's not hurt. Player's calling for maybe saying, hey, we're going to need a substitution here. Gill's down. Looks like maybe it's his ankle. Hope he's okay here. Ooh, yeah, he's grimacing.
That is not a good sign.
No, you never want to see anyone get hurt out here. Uh-oh. Trainers out there. Looks like they're taking a closer look at that right ankle. Oh, boy, yeah. He looks to be in a fair amount of pain here. Luckily, we do right behind the score table. If you can see it, just to the left of the score table, couple people standing up. That's Saskatoon Fire Department. Our Saskatoon Fire Department donates their time. We've got two volunteer firefighter paramedics here the entire tournament for situations just like this. Looks like a couple of these firefighters are going to come down, help the trainer take a look at things. They are here. Couple fellas, when they're not serving their community here with fire and primary paramedic stuff, they're at Brit here.
Yeah, they're That's still awesome. Helping out the community.
Volunteering in their community, got to give a shout out. It's not just, you know, Bedford alumni and students and staff. It's from the wider community as well. Round of applause for Gill.
He's walking off.
He's had a great game and has been a real impact player. Tough to see him leave like this with 16 seconds left. No one feels good about that. No one feels good. Oh, that sucks. Hopefully it's just a tweak that, you know, if he rests and puts some ice on it, puts it up for a day, you know, hopefully he's okay by later in the day.
Does look like they're putting some ice on it over there.
Whoa, nifty little move. Holy cow.
Wow.
He found space where I didn't see any. Just like right between two players. Like, what?
That's number three, Nathan Akapuyan. I pronounced that very wrong.
That's better than I would have done.
And he's only 5'10".
It says he's 5'10". He ain't 5'10". He's more like 5'7", I think.
I think so. They exaggerate a little bit on these sheets.
They do.
Want to look big.
You gotta. Rams up. 2 points, 48-46. 12 seconds to go. Foul called. Of course, Elgin, you got to think, trying to intentionally foul at this point in time to hopefully get a turnover on the inbound, doing something so that they can get the ball back. 10 seconds left in the game, 10 seconds left in the shot clock. They need a turnover here somehow.
They need at least 2 points to bring it to overtime.
To bring it to that tie. Can they do it? St. FX up 2 points, 10 seconds left, looking to inbound. They get it. Foul called again.
We're just running down the clock now.
Another inbound chance. Number four, Caitlin Smith's going to inbound the ball for St. FX. 2 point game. 9.2 seconds left to go now. Kind of play do they have here? Trying to create some space. They get it. Foul called. Compo got the ball and got fouled immediately. Are they in bonus? They're in bonus now. So now we're going to go to the line. This is what, weirdly enough, this is what the Orcas wanted, to kind of get a few more fouls, get them to go to the line. Hopefully, they're hoping that St. FX misses one or two of these, and that they get a rebound and can kind of find some way to tie this up here with under 8 seconds to go. Number seven, Keenan Compo for his first. Hits it. 3-point game. If he hits this one, it becomes a 2-point or two possession game, and you got to think it's out of reach.
I think if he makes this, I think FX wins if he makes this.
I think you're right. If he misses, watch out. He got it. 4-point game, two possessions. Olsen has it. 5 seconds left.
They're not giving up.
Pull up for three. Misses it. Hominick with the rebound.
1.2 seconds left.
Now, technically,
there's a
universe
chance
where it could happen.
They make both the foul shots, get the ball quick, and shoot.
It's possible. Or hit the first, miss the second, grab the rebound, throw it outside as fast as you can for the quickest three-pointer ever.
It might be a little tight.
Yeah, well.
That was not good.
No, that's not what they needed there.
I don't think they have a chance anymore.
No, down four.
Unless they somehow managed to get a three.
50-46. Dominic's going to shoot his second.
No pressure on him, though,
gets
at all.
Gets it. Okay, here we go. 1.6 seconds left. St. FX gets the ball, and this one's over.
A three-point game.
Okay, and at the end of that, what an entertaining game from both sides. Got to congratulate both teams. Coming up a little short, the Elgin Orcas out of Surrey, BC. What an amazing showing at this tournament. Hopefully they had an amazing time. We hope to see them back in the future. And the winner of this game, the St. Francis Xavier Rams out of Edmonton, Alberta, Canada. Rory, thanks for your time here this morning.
Well, thanks for having
me. Let's take a break. Fans at home, stay tuned. This is the Dance Showcase coming up. This is electrifying sports entertainment. Stay tuned for the next hour and a half. After that, we got both the Brit semifinals.